Welcome to Dirty Files. I am very happy to present you the content I have prepared in the genres: true crimes, cold files, serial killers, and many more. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and to stay tuned for more of this content. Here we go. Hello and welcome to our channel. Today we're talking about the heartbreaking and devastating murders of three family members of singer and actress Jennifer Hudson. The killing of three relatives of singer Jennifer Hudson. Jason Hudson and his mother, Darnell Donerson, lost their lives on October 24, 2008. Gunshot injuries were found on their bodies at Donerson's home in Chicago. The report of Jennifer Hudson's family, including her nephew Julian King, age 7, going missing, led to the issuance of an Amber Alert. The body of Julian King was discovered in a car on October 27th in the West Side area of Chicago, matching the description given in the Amber Alert. The autopsy findings showed that Julian King died from multiple gunshot wounds. Chicago police confirmed that the gun discovered in a vacant lot on the west side was the same weapon utilized in the killing. Chicago police detained William Balfour, Julia Hudson's estranged husband, on the same day her mother and brother were discovered deceased, but chose not to formally charge him. Balfour was granted parole after spending close to 7 years in prison for attempted murder, car theft, and possession of a stolen vehicle. Records from the Illinois Department of Corrections show that one of Balfour's addresses is the identical residence where Donerson and Jason Hudson were murdered. After being held by the Chicago police for 48 hours without being charged, Balfour was subsequently taken into custody by the Illinois Department of Corrections for violating parole. At the parole hearing on November 10, 2008, the Cook County State's Attorney's Office notified the Prisoner Review Board that Balfour's former or current girlfriend claimed to have witnessed him possessing a firearm that resembled the murder weapon shortly before the crime. Jorge Montes, the board chairman, mentioned that despite Balfour possibly violating other parole conditions like missing anger management and substance abuse counseling, the gun possession charge justified his custody until a hearing on December 3rd with the Illinois Prisoner Review Board. Montes stated that the woman's allegations involved Balfour admitting his role in the murders, but they were not taken into account during the parole review. Balfour arrived at the hearing without legal representation since he had not been accused of committing any crimes. Balfour was arrested on December 1, 2008 and faced charges for 3 first-degree murder and 1 felony home invasion. The victims were Donerson, Jason Hudson, and King. During a court hearing on December 3rd, bail was denied for Balfour and a prosecutor claimed that he had killed out of anger towards his estranged wife dating someone else. Joshua Kutnick, the attorney for Balfour, stated that his client continued to claim his innocence in the crimes. On December 30th, Balfour was charged with a crime. He entered a plea of not guilty to all charges on January 20th, 2009. Following the deaths, Hudson's family revealed the establishment of the Hudson-King Foundation for Families of Slain Victims, a foundation set up to meet the needs of families who have lost loved ones to violent crimes, as stated in a press release. William Balfour, who has been in custody for nearly 4 years, broke his silence in court for the first time as he prepared to receive his sentence on Tuesday for the killings of 3 of singer Jennifer Hudson's relatives, expressing sympathy for the youngest victim. He expressed his heartfelt condolences towards Julian King, Hudson's 7-year-old nephew who admired Balfour, his stepfather, and had a bright smile. "I had deep feelings for him. I continue to adore him," Balfour expressed while gazing at his own family in the crowded courtroom, rather than at the Chicago superstar or her relatives seated on the other side. The courtroom momentarily came to a standstill. Sensuous, Balfour's sister, started crying and quickly exited through a side door. Jennifer Hudson and her sister, Julia, who is Balfour's ex-wife, were seated next to each other, holding tissues and wiping their eyes. It was an unusual moment during a court hearing that lacked suspense. According to Illinois legislation, Judge Charles Burns was required to give Balfour a life sentence with no chance of parole due to his multiple murder convictions. Numerous people in the courtroom were expecting to hear either testimony or written statements from Jennifer Hudson and her sister regarding the terrible effects the crimes have had on their lives. However, since the sentence was already decided, the sisters decided to keep their sorrow to themselves. The security team that had guarded the Oscar-winning actress and her family during the trial swiftly escorted them to and from the courthouse on Tuesday via the basement. Following the hearing, not a single lawyer in the case spoke to the crowd of journalists gathered in the lobby of the Layton Criminal Court building. Shortly after learning that Jennifer Hudson was no longer present, the microphones were quickly brought down. While it was expected, the judge became emotional while delivering the sentence, attacking Balfour for his claims of loving Julian as insulting to everyone. In a trembling voice, Burns told Balfour, "Your heart is like a frigid night, and your soul is as desolate as empty space." Ultimately, the judge sentenced Balfour to life in prison for each murder, along with an additional 120 years for other crimes. Burns claimed to be confident that Balfour murdered Julian because he was a potential witness against him and a hindrance. Prosecutors stated that Hudson's mother, Darnell Donerson, 57, and her brother, Jason Hudson, 29, had already been killed in their family home in Englewood. "Julian opened up his life to you. Burns definitely admired you," he said. "I have no reservations he admired you while you were loading bullets into his head. I only wish that his fear did not last long." In May, Balfour was found guilty of the triple murder by a Cook County jury. Prosecutors claimed that Balfour was angry about his failing marriage to Julia Hudson and envious that she was in a relationship with someone else. During the court hearing on Tuesday, Gregory King, Julian's father, was seen sitting slouched on the witness stand, trying to hold back tears as he remembered the intense three-day hunt for his son. The search concluded when Julian's body was discovered inside Jason Hudson's stolen SUV on the west side, similar to the other two individuals he was killed by gunfire. He said it felt as if a piece of his heart was forcefully torn away all at once. "I was filled with despair. I was consumed with anger towards William Balfour, the man who killed my." King also mentioned with great sadness the things he missed about his son, like picking him up from school and going on field trips together. King mentioned that he even longed for his teasing about SpongeBob SquarePants, a cartoon character that he was somewhat scared of. In the course of the two-hour hearing, prosecutors brought in multiple victims of Balfour's previous criminal activities, illustrating a portrait of a man who became a gang member at 15, sold crack cocaine, and participated in other illegal activities. Charles Gardner, aged 48, stated that he witnessed Balfour stealing his SUV in November 1998. He then jumped onto the luggage rack, leading to a hectic police pursuit across various Southside neighborhoods and the Dan Ryan Expressway, reaching speeds of almost 100 miles per hour in an attempt to dislodge Balfour from the roof. Jennifer Hudson looked over at her sister while Gardner gave his testimony, at one moment placing her hand on her temple and shaking her head with a disbelieving smile. Balfour was taken into custody and later admitted guilt for attempted murder and stealing a vehicle. After serving a 7-year prison sentence, he was still under parole supervision when the triple murder occurred in October 2008. Balfour plans to submit an appeal. The defense raised a point in requesting a new trial, rejected by the judge on Tuesday, arguing that Jennifer Hudson's testimony should not have been permitted as she had no firsthand knowledge of the murders and her fame biased the jury. A Chicago judge, having a hard time controlling his anger, handed down a life sentence on Tuesday to Jennifer Hudson's ex-brother-in-law, who was convicted of killing her mother, brother, and 7-year-old nephew in a jealous outburst, according to prosecutors. In scathing remarks, Judge Charles Burns of Cook County Circuit Court dismissed William Balfour's assertion of innocence in the crimes. Burns said to Balfour, "You possess the essence of a cold Arctic evening. Your soul is as empty as the void of darkness." Balfour was found guilty in May of first-degree murder for the 2008 shooting deaths of Hudson's mother, Darnell Donerson, brother Jason Hudson, and nephew Julian King, who was only 7 years old. In court, Balfour was depicted by the prosecutors as a jealous ex-husband of Julia Hudson, sister of Hudson, who frequently stalked the family home after leaving in early 2008. Balfour's lawyers proposed that another person was responsible for a crime at the family's 3-story residence in the Englewood area on the south side of Chicago. Burns made his most severe remarks on Tuesday concerning Julian's death. The judge's voice broke as he remembered how scared the child must have been right before getting shot in the head 2 times. The judge said he was certain that he saw you shoot him in the head. During the entire trial earlier this year, Hudson was present every day and sat beside her sister, wiping her eyes with a tissue a few times while Burns expressed his anger for 10 minutes. She chose not to speak to the judge and exited the courtroom without saying anything. Prosecutors reported that Balfour left in Jason Hudson's SUV with Julian, Julia's son, and proceeded to shoot the boy multiple times in the head while he was positioned behind a front seat. His body was discovered in the deserted car several miles away following a search that lasted 3 days. For 3 days, the boy's body remained under a tarp in the back seat of the SUV, Burns explained, similar to how you discard garbage and allow it to decay. Despite the fact that Balfour will probably not live to see freedom again, the judge specifically stated that the sentences for his crimes will be consecutive, with an extra 120 years for his various convictions like burglary, abduction, and car theft. Julian's father, Gregory King, was the sole family member who spoke, recounting 3 days of hoping for his son's survival before discovering his tragic fate. He also talked about the things he had lost due to his son's death, the small moments that create a bond between a father and son. King expressed his longing for picking Julian up from the school bus. "I miss going on outings with him. I also long for his teasing me about SpongeBob SquarePants, a cartoon character he was somewhat scared of." Jennifer Hudson decided not to express any thoughts. In court, the Academy Award-winning actress from the 2007 movie Dreamgirls said she had known Balfour since middle school and never liked him. Jennifer Hudson's former brother-in-law was convicted of murdering her mother, brother, and young nephew on Friday. He was found guilty in the homicide trial. Constantly watched by the media, Ms. Hudson, who became famous after coming from a tough neighborhood in the city, participated in the trial that lasted nearly 3 weeks. She also testified first for the prosecution, exposing her long-lasting hatred for William Balfour, who was ultimately convicted in the trial. Ms. Hudson continuously advised her sister, Julia, not to marry William, but she still decided to go through with it. Prosecutors brought forward more than 80 witnesses, claiming that Mr. Balfour killed the Hudson family in their Englewood residence in October 2008 because of jealousy and possessiveness towards Julia Hudson. The lawyers of Mr. Balfour stated that the case relied mostly on indirect evidence, suggesting that the police focused on Mr. Balfour promptly to resolve a prominent case. At 31 years old, Mr. Balfour is facing the prospect of being imprisoned for the rest of his life. Prosecutors said Mr. Balfour went to the Hudson family home in the morning of the shootings, and witnesses saw him with the gun earlier. Nevertheless, there were no DNA samples or fingerprints to prove Mr. Balfour's participation. Defense attorneys proposed to the jury that Jason, Ms. Hudson's brother, could have been the one behind the shootings as a result of his participation in drug trafficking. The jury, consisting of 6 men and 6 women, spent some time deliberating over 3 days, and just before reaching their verdict, they had revealed that they were divided. They were isolated during the discussions in the high-profile trial. The trial's daily operations were not strongly related to Ms. Hudson's fame, although it was always noticeable. Reports from the trial highlighted her crying, her lowered head, her position in the fourth row, her exits from the courtroom, and her attire. Ms. Hudson gained nationwide fame after appearing on American Idol in 2004, and later won an Academy Award for her performance in Dreamgirls. The trial served as a reminder of the extent to which her life had changed. Ms. Hudson, who stated that she started singing at a Baptist church in this area when she was 7 years old, had moved out of her mother's residence in Englewood. It is an area known for violence, where her sister held various positions, such as working at a Burger King and being a school bus driver. Shortly before they died, Ms. Hudson informed the jury that she had left signed empty checks for her mother, Darnell Donerson, to cover expenses such as the household gas bill. She had also purchased a computer for her sister and gifted her brother an SUV, which was presumably the same vehicle in which her nephew, 7-year-old Julian King, was tragically discovered dead. The young boy's lifeless left arm stuck out from under a grimy shower curtain, laying on the back seat of the deserted white SUV. Among the scattered trash and empty pop bottles, Jennifer Hudson's 7-year-old nephew, Julian King, was found dead with 2 gunshot wounds to the back of his head. It was a terrible conclusion to an already sad situation. News reporters arrived at the scene. Helicopters hovered over the West Side on that Monday morning in October 2008, while Chicago police detectives meticulously photographed the boy's body and documented all evidence in the vehicle. Jurors were presented with detailed evidence on Monday during the second week of William Balfour's trial. He is accused of shooting Hudson's mother, Darnell Donerson, and brother Jason Hudson in response to his anger over Hudson's sister, Julia, seeking a divorce from him. Prosecutors claim that Balfour abducted Julian and shot him in Jason Hudson's stolen SUV, then abandoned the vehicle on South Colon Avenue in the 1300 block. Investigators spent hours on Monday searching the vehicle, dusting it for fingerprints and using special lights on carpets and upholstery to find possible evidence. Attorneys for Balfour have stated that, despite a thorough forensic examination, there is no physical evidence such as fingerprints, DNA, or gunshot residue linking Balfour to the murders. Balfour remained stoic during Monday's testimony, only turning to look at photos of Julian's injured body. Just last week, he had cried while viewing autopsy images shown by prosecutors. The SUV was discovered on October 27, 2008, just 3 days following the shootings at the Hudson family residence in the Englewood community. The following day, investigators divided approximately 90 new graduates from the Chicago Police Academy into 2 teams to search the region spanning from the West Side apartment, where Balfour was apprehended, to the street where the SUV was located, about 2 miles apart. Officer Terrence Fowler stated on Monday that he had only walked about 1 block into the search, side by side with fellow officers, when he swung his metal baton through tall weeds and debris and made contact with an object. Fowler stated that he heard a clink. "I utilized my baton to clear some rubble aside, and that's when I noticed a firearm." Prosecutors claim that the handgun, a .45 caliber weapon, was taken from Jason Hudson a few weeks before the murders and was discovered near the SUV where Julian's body was found. Judge Charles Burns agreed to allow the release of the 911 recording where Julia Hudson pleaded for help after discovering her mother had been shot, before the start of testimony on Monday, as requested by the Tribune and other news outlets. The vocalist's sibling came home from her job to find a gunshot mark on the entrance and her mother lying on the ground, dead and covered in blood. After leaving the house, she dialed 911 without knowing her brother was also deceased inside or that Julian was nowhere to be found. In the call that lasted almost 3 minutes, Julia Hudson could be heard crying, while the emergency dispatcher seemed to initially minimize the seriousness of her words. She seemed to understand that her mother might not be the sole person in danger. She inquired about the location of her brother. After a short time, she informed a person close by that she was unable to locate her son. An ex-friend and neighbor of Jennifer Hudson's family testified today that he witnessed William Balfour watching the Hudson's house late at night during the summer before three of the singer's family members were murdered. Reginald Jones, aged 55, stated in court that he was close friends with Jason Hudson, the brother of Hudson, and regularly helped out the family by doing various chores like walking their dog, repairing cars, and running errands. Jones, who confessed to a crack cocaine addiction, also purchased drugs from Jason Hudson and sometimes assisted him in selling small amounts of crack from their residence in Englewood. Jones stated that during the summer of 2008, he was returning to the back of the Hudson residence when he was surprised by Balfour, who was sitting in the dark at the bottom of the rear stairs below the bedroom window of his estranged wife, Julia Hudson, who is Jennifer Hudson's sister. While I was walking, someone asked me, "Reggie, why are you here?" Jones gave testimony. "I was surprised by it." Balfour, age 30, allegedly shot Jason Hudson, age 29, his mother Darnell Donerson, aged 57, and 7-year-old Julian King on October 24, 2008, reportedly due to his anger over his wife seeking a divorce and being in a new relationship. During a difficult questioning, Jones confessed to occasionally being present at the Hudson residence and assisting customers in purchasing cocaine from Jason Hudson, who was shot in the leg during a previous home invasion and had limited mobility. Jones also stated that he assisted Jason Hudson in transforming cocaine into crack in one of the home's kitchens. That testimony supports defense arguments that the murders could have been a result of Jason Hudson's drug business. During another testimony, Maria Wilkes, aged 17, recounted how Balfour came up to her in an Englewood park in the summer of 2008 and began talking about his wife and her infidelity. Wilkes, who was 13 years old at the time, recounted how he was having a conversation with someone discussing their wife's infidelity. He recently mentioned that she has a new boyfriend and expressed his reluctance to end things with her. He acknowledged that he would need to come to terms with the situation. Wilkes, a resident of the area who was not very acquainted with Balfour, mentioned that one summer day she was strolling along Yale Avenue when she caught sight of Balfour and Julia Hudson having a disagreement outdoors. Wilkes said that he heard him threaten to kill her and her family if she called the police. During questioning from Balfour's lawyer, Edward Kozaboski, Wilkes admitted that she had not shared her story with the police and only revealed it when prosecutors contacted her in July. She also mentioned that she did not catch any of Julia Hudson's words during the reported dispute. Arrangements for the arrival of Jennifer Hudson, the singer and actress who is a cherished figure in Chicago, at the city's criminal courthouse were intricate and planned for several months. A private entrance was set up. Reporters were asked to sign agreements to follow strict courtroom etiquette, and prospective jurors were questioned about their familiarity with American Idol and Dreamgirls. However, once Ms. Hudson finally showed up in court on Monday, the excitement about her successful ascent to fame was swiftly replaced by the grim reality of the tragic events that led her there. The tragic murders of her 7-year-old nephew, her brother, and her mother in the rough South Side neighborhood of Englewood in Chicago. The glamour was completely taken away. "Yes, that is my mother," declared Ms. Hudson during Monday afternoon's testimony. When she was shown a photo, Ms. Hudson informed the jurors that she had shared a bed with her mother until she reached the age of 16. As a grown-up, she mentioned that she stayed in touch with her mother daily, usually through text messages that started coming in early mornings. In October 2008, Ms. Hudson testified that nothing showed up one morning, which was the first sign of trouble. In a murder trial against William Balfour, Ms. Hudson, the first witness for the prosecution, testified that Balfour shot her family members in 2008 out of jealousy and possessiveness towards his wife, Julia Hudson, who is Ms. Hudson's sister. It was clear that Jennifer Hudson, known for her stint on American Idol in 2004 and her Academy Award-winning role as Effie in Dreamgirls, was the most highly awaited individual in this case. There was speculation about when and whether she would step up to the witness stand until the moment she did so. Ultimately, she responded to inquiries for approximately 30 minutes, with the judge stopping occasionally to allow her to collect herself and encouraging her, at a certain moment, to raise her voice and speak more slowly. Ms. Hudson mentioned that she was away in Florida in 2008 when her family members lost their lives. She immediately returned home and went to the Cook County Medical Examiner's office to identify her mother, Darnell Donerson, her brother, Jason Hudson, and her young nephew, Julian King, who were discovered in their family home and in an SUV that had been stolen. Mr. Balfour, who attended primary school with Ms. Hudson and who could receive a life sentence, has entered a plea of not guilty. In a statement at the beginning of the week, his attorney implied that Ms. Hudson's fame had caused police to feel extra urgency in solving the case, resulting in a swift focus on Mr. Balfour without any solid proof against him. However, a prosecutor claimed that Mr. Balfour, who was not on good terms with Julia Hudson, had made multiple threats against her, including promising to harm her family before targeting her. Both legal teams seemed to only find common ground on one aspect, a bleak depiction of life in Englewood, a community where drug dealing flourished and gunshots were often shrugged off as they were a common occurrence. Jennifer Hudson informed the jury that she had never liked Mr. Balfour, not during their time together in the sixth grade class in Englewood, nor afterwards. She said that none of us were in favor of her marrying him. Jennifer Hudson told the jurors that she made an effort to stay away from William whenever possible. I made an effort to avoid being where he was. While married to Julia Hudson for a short time, William Balfour appeared to fully accept the responsibilities of being a stepfather. He announced his pride as a parent on MySpace and adorned his page with pictures of a happy Julian King. The boy is also cited in a 7-line autobiography that Balfour created for the social media platform. They were frequently spotted walking to the park or having barbecues on the front lawn of their Englewood block. Neighbors say Balfour, 27, used the money he made working as a cozy baker to help provide for his new family and often took his stepson on boys-only outings to Popeyes and McDonald's. The authenticity of Balfour's affection appeared so strong that loved ones find it hard to accept the caring stepfather as the person authorities suspect in the murder of the 7-year-old boy. Authorities suspect that the shooting death of Julian is connected to the killings of his grandmother, Darnell Donerson, and his uncle, Jason Hudson, which occurred on Friday. Neighbor Auntie Moore stated that the guy they are discussing is completely different from the guy she knew. I'm not claiming he was perfect, but I do believe he was making an effort to change his life for the better. Police identified Balfour as a suspect in an Amber Alert issued on Friday. He is currently located at the Statesville Correctional Center in Joliet as he is suspected of committing murder, which violated his parole. Balfour has a history of criminal offenses that spans at least 10 years. Court documents indicate that Balfour was taken into custody in 1998 when law enforcement officers observed him operating a vehicle that had been reported as stolen. According to court records, they attempted to stop him near the 6900 block of South Yale Avenue, close to the Hudson family home. But Balfour stopped the vehicle and ran away. Thank you for tuning in. If you thought this video was helpful, please like, share, and remember to subscribe to our channel for additional detailed stories. Click on the bell icon to receive notification of our most recent videos.